Hi guys, this is Vincent, and in this tutorial I'm going to demonstrate Luminar 4's AI Sky replacement technology. I have version 4.2, which was just a soft release, and in this new version they have also added the AI Augmented Sky, which allows you to add objects in your sky, which I'm going to show you an example of. So in this image, I have a bland or simple blue sky. I downloaded this image on Pixabay, which is a great source to get copyright-free images. I'll put a link for that in the description below. So now I'm just going to get started with replacing the sky first. So I'm going to go to the Creative tab in Luminar 4. And here I have the AI Sky Replacement tool. And what I'm going to do is just replace it with one of the predefined skies. I'll just give you an example of one here, which is a Galaxy One. And you can also add your own sky or load your custom sky if you have it saved on your hard disk. But for this example, I'm going to go with the Dramatic Sunset 2. And as you can see, it automatically created the mask and replaced the sky without messing up the tree or the tree branches and so forth. The foreground or the grass does need to be relighted. So I'm just going to go to the relight scene here and just drag it all the way to the right to make the sky match the foreground. And I also noticed the sky here on the left middle portion here and the right portion here not masking too well. So what I'll try to do is adjust the horizon blending, which softens the transition of the sky to the horizon. See if that makes any difference. So I move that all the way to the left, then I'll change the position of the sky, drop it down a little, and that made it look much better. And now for the sky here on the tree, I just want to double check the tree and the mask area here. So there is a little bit of artifact or a little bit more noise in this area compared to the rest of the sky. So let me see if I can I change the texture to Sky Global. And that doesn't make too much of a difference. And I will put a description or a link to all these advanced tools in the description below. So I didn't make any changes. So let me see. The close gaps. This changes the details of the mask, so this should adjust it a little bit. I'll just keep it at 7 or 8. Actually, 7 looks good. So let me double check 6. Okay, I'll just keep it at 6 for now, which looks pretty good. And the sky looks pretty good now. I can also defocus or blur up the sky if I want, but I'm not going to. And now I'm going to go to the AI Augmented Sky right here. And here I can replace or put some objects in the sky. So if I want, I can put some birds. If I want, I can also put some fireworks. So it depends on what type of image you have. Not every object or every pre-built-in object will go with your sky. So just choose accordingly, or you can load your own custom image. In this example, I'll probably go with the balloon, which is the easiest one to place and blend in. So I'm just going to place the object, decrease the size here. That looks good, and I'm just gonna defocus it or blur it a little. I'm gonna try to relight it, see if that looks good. And there you go. So this is version 4.2 of Luminar 4, so I replaced the sky, did a little bit of adjustments to it, and then I used the AI Augmented Sky to place the balloon. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up or subscribe. Have a good one.